Hi everyone, welcome back to this series of Project Management Key Concepts, where we're delving deeper into the concepts within the project management body of knowledge. This one in particular is the cause and effect diagram that you might see as part of quality or even problem solving within your project. Now, what is a cause and effect diagram? Basically, it breaks down the causes of a problem or a problem statement which has been identified, and it breaks it down into discrete branches. So it's a method of brainstorming, in other words, and we usually have our problem statement at the end here, and it looks like a fish or a fishbone, which is why it's also known as a fishbone diagram. But all of these branches, so our brainstorming branches that we break our problem down into, help identify the main or the root cause of a problem. Now, it's also called an Ishikawa diagram, after Keoru Ishikawa from the University of Tokyo, who basically invented this idea. Let's look at a quick example. The problem statement is placed at the head of the fish or the fishbone, for example. And the reasons are brainstormed in the categories that you might choose. Some popular categories that you'll find are people, information, process, and system, or PIPS as it's known. This is pretty well known in lean or Toyota production system circles. You might also see in manufacturing the man, method, machine, and material. So you can put anything you like here, but this just gives us a framework to view the problem through. So what information are our people not getting? Or you know, maybe do we have the right people on board here? Or is the process not up to scratch? Do we need to change the process for what we're doing to fix this particular problem? Or is the system hindering us? So do we have the wrong system? Is there a bug in the system? Is the system not quite up to scratch? Is it not performing as we expected? All of those things might contribute to the problem, and that's just the lens that we view our problem through to help us find the real cause or the root cause of our problem. And that is a cause and effect diagram.